The moon is like a giant ball, and most countries that land there aim for the middle. It's sunny, flat, and easy. But India, they aimed for the bottom, the South Pole, a place no one had ever landed before. Why? Because that's where the treasure is. India's moon adventure started in 2008 with Chandrayaan 1. It didn't land, it just went around the moon like a scout plane. And it spotted something amazing. Tiny bits of frozen water hiding in the dust. No lakes or puddles, more like glitter-sized ice. But in space, that's huge. You can drink it, turn it into air, or even rocket fuel. Next in 2019 came Chandrayaan 2. This one had a lander called Vikram and a rover named Pragyan. The orbiter worked perfectly and still does today, but the lander, it fell a little too fast. Okay, a lot too fast, and it crashed. Sad, but also useful, because engineers learned what to fix. Then came Chandrayaan 3 in 2023. No orbiter this time, the old one still up there, working. This lander had stronger legs, better brakes, and smarter software. And on August 23rd, it gently touched down near the moon's south pole, something no country had ever done. The rover rolled out, found sulfur in the soil, measured temperatures, and explored for 2 weeks, which is how long the moon stays sunny before the freezing night sets in. So why go to the moon's south pole if it's colder, darker, and bumpier? Because there might be way more ice there than anywhere else. And ice is basically the Swiss Army knife of space. Water for drinking, oxygen for breathing, and fuel for going even further. All this for about $75 million, less than the budget of some space movies, from spotting water, to crash landing, to being the first ever at South Pole. Chandrayaan is proof you don't need to be the richest country to aim for the moon and make history.